Today I want to talk to you about troubleshooting two-wire systems with a milliamp clamp meter. If you're working with two-wire systems, a milliamp clamp meter is a must. All the manufacturers recommend you have one of these. The Irrigation Association teaches that you need to have one of these. These are a gotta-have tool for a two-wire system. The reason they are a must-have is because two-wire systems work on milliamps, and this meter, called the Pro 93 milliamp clamp meter, can measure milliamps. There aren't very many multimeters out there that can do that, so when you go to select a multimeter to do this job, make sure absolutely it has the milliamp capability. On this unit, the milliamp capability is shown here by the MA. When I move the dial to the MA's position, it's now ready to measure milliamps. The way you measure milliamps is through the clamp portion of it. You take one, not two, but one wire of the system, and you're going to put it through that clamp, and it's going to give you a reading here of what your milliamps are. Okay. Now, what we're looking for when we're trying to troubleshoot this is, what is the drop in milliamps from one decoder to the next? So let me take you through a chart or a diagram that will show you how that works. So this is what a typical two-wire system looks like, and this is a diagram of how you would use a Pro 93 in that system to diagnose. Out of your two-wire controller comes a certain amount of milliamp current that is measurable by the 93. So you see in the first instance here on the elbow, the 93 is going to measure, and let's say there's 200 milliamps coming out of that controller. Then you see a series of decoders here. In this case, we have three of them, but the system is going to continue on down. Typically, a decoder will draw 0.6 milliamp per decoder, but specs will change based on manufacturer. It might be higher, couldn't be a whole lot lower. But as you test, as we see here in the third 93 here, you're going to test on one leg of the two-wire system wiring that comes into the decoder. Again, you don't want to test both wires because it tends to cancel itself out. You get zero for a reading. So you're going to test on one side, and you're going to take a milliamp clamp or a milliamp reading on the inbound of that decoder. Let's say in this diagram we start off with 200 milliamps and each one takes 0.6. I want to see a 0.6 milliamp drop across the decoder every time I test. So on the inbound, let's say if I've got 100 milliamp, on the outbound of that decoder, I should see 99.4. And the next one, I should see 99.4 milliamps coming into the decoder, and on the outbound, it should say 98.8, and so on down the line. You know you have a fault when you get to a decoder where the inbound and the outbound are not 0.6 milliamp different. So if you drop by 30 milliamps on the inbound and the outbound of a certain decoder, you know that that decoder is bad. That's the beauty of these things. But the only way you can do that is if you have a meter, a clamp, that can measure milliamps, and that's what the Pro 93 can do. In addition, you also want to have a true RMS capability on your multimeter. True RMS means that the meter is accurate 100% of the time, no matter what your AC sine wave looks like. Square wave, sine wave, distorted wave, it doesn't make a difference. It's going to be accurate all the time. If you just get an averaging milliamp clamp meter, it may or may not be accurate. Now, is it going to be off by, you know, tremendous amounts? No, but you want the most accurate meter you can get, and they're really not that much more expensive to get a true RMS version.